This will certainly get everybody fired up. NHL Now all-women show, Jackie, Jamie, and Kendall Coyne Schofield, Tuesday, March 5th, 4 p.m. Eastern. Hockey is for everyone, and that's certainly a great theme as we get to visit one-on-one with Kendall Coyne Schofield. This movement continues to grow, and I know you feel strongly about the momentum. How fired up are you about being on that show tomorrow?
I'm just as excited as I was at the All-Star Skills Competition to join Jackie and Jamie on NHL Network with the all-women show tomorrow.
You mentioned the All-Star Skills Competition. Those of you that have watched her knew what was coming, but it seemed like the widespread mass appeal of that moment was huge. What was it like for you?
It was breathtaking. The moment I heard that I was going to be the first woman to compete in the NHL All-Star Skills Competition, I don't know how that doesn't take your breath away, but
flying.
Just to see the impact it's had on so many people, the doors that have been opened, and the perceptions that have been changed about the game of hockey forever.
And we heard Connor McDavid before this segment started. The respect, the esteem, the more I'm around hockey players, whether they're sled hockey players, women's hockey players, or men's hockey players, you're all the same. You respect and appreciate the skill of others. What was it like, though, to hear players like Connor McDavid react to you the way they did?
It was tremendous, and I think it really validates what we do day in and day out. And we all are hockey players, and we all put in the same work. And for me to be able to showcase that our game is as fast as the men's game on the National Hockey League stage, and to hear Connor McDavid say that as well, was pretty special.
And we see you in action here. We know you wore the C for that recent three-game challenge between Team USA and Team Canada. I know how much of an impact that had on USA hockey fans. How meaningful was it for you to wear the C?
Oh, it's a tremendous honor. When you play for the national team, the team is made up of elite leaders, and everyone leads in their own way. Whether you have a letter on your jersey or not, you're a leader, and you represent your country. And I was tremendously honored to be in that position and voted by my teammates as a captain, and excited to continue leading going forward.
And I think back to what we saw 2017 at the World Championship, Team USA and Team Canada go to OT. And you talked about the fact that you don't have to wear a letter to be a leader. Hillary Knight scored what proved to be the golden goal. She gave you credit for helping get her going. That's something that you take pride in your game. It's not just pace and speed. There's an intensity. Where does that come from?
It's knowing your teammates. And that's what's so awesome about being a part of a team sport is everyone has a different personality. Everyone gets going in their own unique way. And knowing Hillary so well and playing with her over the years, I know what it takes, you know, maybe to give her a little bump and say, hey, let's go. Let's get going here. And that's exactly what happened. And we were able to come away with a victory in the World Championships on home soil for the first time, which was unbelievable.
And then 20 years between Olympic gold, 2018, 1998, it's a moment that's treasured by USA hockey fans. As time passes, here we are in 2019, it's been over a year. What's your biggest takeaway, your fondest recollection of what happened?
There's been a lot after, you know, looking back a year from now, and I think it's the impact that it's had on so many people.
Yeah.
A lot of us were in that game because we were impacted by the 1998 team.
Sure.
And we wanted to go to the Olympics because of them. And to sit back here and 20 years later, now hearing from so many young girls saying, I want to go to the Olympics, I want to win a gold medal because of you, and seeing the growth of the game across the United States is pretty cool.
I've got goosebumps. When you look at these pictures, how do you feel?
Speechless.
Seriously.
It's hard to put into words because you think of the combination of hard work, sacrifice, how much sacrifice my parents put into making that dream a reality.
Sure.
And just the joy of representing your country at the highest level and the pinnacle of our sport. That's our Stanley Cup. That's our Super Bowl. That's everything to us. So to be able to accomplish a childhood dream is unbelievable because you can preach to kids your dream can come true.
Oh, sure can and sure has. You mentioned family. Kendall Coyne Schofield. It is a special, special love that you and your husband share. Both of you such high achievers. Help us understand how it works because the scheduling has to be very challenging.
Yeah, sometimes we see each other in the stands and it's a quick wave and we'll see you the next day. But as elite athletes in life and as a couple, we support each other day
sure.
in, day out. And it does get challenging, but when we get to see each other, it makes that time even more special because we're physically with each other.
Sure. And he's able to watch you not only play, but also excel on TV. We've seen you a variety of different roles, obviously excelling with us here. We've seen you between the benches. Why is broadcasting something you're passionate about?
I'm so passionate about it because we always say you can't be what you can't see. Mm. And to be a woman in this role, I hope it inspires young girls to want to be an analyst one day, to watch sports and know that they can talk sports, that no matter what, their voices are just as important as maybe a man's voice, and they can speak the game.
And you have a credibility because of the way you play and because of your sophistication as a player. Do you find that there is respect out there that you've earned and you deserve when you're around the game?
Definitely, and we saw that at the All-Star Skills Competition when you heard the players talking about our
That's
game.
Right.
I was talking with Patrick Kane and Connor McDavid, and you know they're asking what's next for your schedule? When are the World Championships?
That's awesome.
They know what's going on. They're fans of our sport as we are of them, and so definitely.
When you look at the men's game and you look at the women's game, when you draw a comparison between the two, what is it?
I would say one of the biggest differences is size. Our game players are predominantly smaller. You look at me, for example, I'm 5'2". Maybe we'll see a 5'2 player in the NHL one day. I don't know. But the game is fast. The game is skilled. And I think what's the same is up here.
Sure.
You can't teach that. And elite players have the brains to play the game and make those rash, quick decisions that lead to pucks in the back of the net.
You mentioned hockey sense, and that's a fascinating element to your game. We always focus on the explosiveness, the speed, the pace, the quickness that you play with, but you're never in a rush, you're never in a hurry. How are you able to play so fast yet be under control?
That's one of the hardest challenges as a fast player, is you want to do everything at 110%.
Sure.
However, I had to learn early on in my career, I can't do everything fast. I need to learn how to manage my speed, be in the right position, not overskate the puck. Because if I do overskate the puck, I'm not going to be in a position to score. I'm not going to be in a position to set my teammate up. So it's so important to be able to use that speed effectively and not just skate and aimlessly around the arena.
Mm-hmm. You are an outstanding teammate as we see you setting up your fellow USA hockey players, and we know you're going to be a great teammate with Jackie and Jamie. We're looking forward to NHL Now. Have a great time with that.
Thank you so much, Tony. I'm looking forward to it too.